Hi guys, it's Michelle here. Just want to share with you my currently working on a vintage sewing junk journal. I've done one already, so I've collected a reasonable proportion of ephemera. So you actually have got my box in front of you. I just want to show you some of the page ideas that I'm currently working on. Now in front of you, I've just opened this particular page for you to see. I do understand that this one is heavily collaged and it has a lot of ephemera. I just can't help myself. Admittedly, journaling comes second, ephemera comes first. That's just my personal opinion. So, in front of you, what have you got? We've got an old vintage. This is a vintage tape measure. It's got a real plasticky feel to this particular one. It's probably more likely that it was used in the building trade than it was a tape measure for material, but I just think it adds a little bit of interest. We've got an old vintage hook and eye little card here, and it's got its little metal hooks, which I just think is pretty twee. What I've done is actually sewn it straight into the book page, and I've worked another button card at the back, so both it actually has two pieces of ephemera through the page. We've got a little needles and pin card, and this one is hooked on with just a paper clip, and so this could hold maybe little tag along those lines. The needles have been taken out mostly because I don't want anybody to find themselves injured. I like to go out of my way and collect. I do like to have a good rummage and a hunt around, in my case, car boot sales or charity shops, and you can find wonderful thread cards. And I mean, this is a nice barber's one and it appeals to me. I've also taken advantage that you can, I mean, I wish I was a wonderful seamstress, I'm not. So I have to take advantage of pickup patterns. And just to add a little bit of interest onto the blank page before I start, I have used some of the pattern paper and just glued onto both sections here. And just thinking about what you can actually just get in a little bit of the writing, and here I would imagine that is the zip. Taking bits and pieces from pin interest, I've just got this little camera here and that just acts as a stopper, so when I put the thread card in, it isn't going to slide immediately out of the bottom of the page. If we go across to the second one, I'll lift this one up. The background is actually done on scented draw liners and it's been heavily grunged using tea staining. I have a tendency to occasionally squeeze the tea bag right across the paper. It does take a reasonable portion of time to dry, but it gives another wonderful effect. So we have got ephemera that I've picked up, which I have literally glued straight onto the page. We have some Etsy purchases. I think this is Nick the booksmith here, and she's got like a sewing section. If by any chance one of my wonderful friends have made me a crochet doily, I will enclose them in my journals. I can't crochet at all, never tried, so it is a delight to receive something that's been handmade and with all that time. Now, I've put it on a motifs background, but this particular motif's background would have held something with sequins on more than likely, and I just thought it added a little interest to this page. And yet again, we've just got this wonderful young lady just showing you sort of like I felt as if it went along with these beautiful satin bows, and she's all lavishly dressed. If we go across to the second page here, I'm going to take the middle centre out. Now I've worked with vintage postcards. It'll be easier if I pop this down. So we've got this wonderful young lady here, which I've literally glued onto this tuck spot. We have another thread card, but this time I've actually kept the threads on. So this is As I Found It. We have a vintage bus ticket. And it just happens to have, I felt as if the colours, the auburn brown there, that sort of gave it a nice feel to this page. And my attempt at sewing, this is a piece of blanket that I've purchased and my first attempt at blanket stitch. And yet again, that just adds a little bit of interest. That little tag goes in so. Behind, you'll just see the glimpse of a pattern. And also, we've just got an old vintage wall stamp coupon sheet here. It just adds a little bit more of the ephemera, and just adds interest, doesn't it, really? And I'm sure at a later spot, if anybody wanted to put some more journaling cards in, they certainly could. Using some of my vintage books, I've taken out some of the advertisements, and I've done a lot of layering here. We have a vintage British snap here with the snaps on, so I've put those on. We've just got anything from little tops of threads and sewing. We've got bits and pieces from, this goes on to lovely vintage dolls. We've got a button card at the back here. We've just got a little bit of sewing ephemera from a sewing book. An idea of, if you do get a chance, think about looking out for vintage sewing books. This happens to be a Singer. I do think that it becomes a real great inspiration to look out there, see what you can find. I mean, there are just some awesome bibs and bobs that can be. And then I just have a tendency to use some of the adverts in the back because it pleases me. And I just think that that is a great way to reinvent the books, really. And behind, we've just got an old piece of ephemera. I was very lucky that I've got myself a vintage viewfinder, and I do have some of the little picture reels, and so I've just used that ephemera and tucked it in the back. So it's a mixture of sewing and just vintage ephemera. Now, as you saw, this page is currently still blank. It goes back like so. And we have an advert here for shoes, and which I've backed with another page from the book, The Dolls, that I was going on about. So this tells you in the 1770s how the dolls evolved into different styles as more and more features were available to them. And I've used this as a tuck spot. And this yet again has more vintage thread cards. So this is for hosiery mending, and more threads applied on that one. And one of my very first little journaling spots. And this is just graph paper, tea stained up and stamped accordingly. And then I probably used a little credit card and drew round, and then I have neatly folded it up like so. So that adds a little spot for journaling. Now the time is getting on and I don't want you to be bored, so I'll just show you this one as my last page. Again, we've just got an old card. This would have been our old Hook and Eyes, and this goes on to say war conditions. Owing to the government restrictions with regard to the use of metal, these hooks and eyes are not now made of the usual rustless metal, but being extra japanned will be found practically rust proof. So there's a vintage backing with another little vintage travel ticket from the buses, a heavily coffee stained tag that I've made and stamped up, and we've got some little pieces of vellum here which has been stuck down, and more sewing pattern paper in the background. Well, I hope you enjoyed me flicking through just a few of my pages for my latest vintage sewing junk journal. Catch up with you later, guys. Bye bye.